22-year-old Bengaluru climate activist Disha Ravi was finally granted bail by a Delhi court in connection to Delhi police's ongoing toolkit probe. Here's a timeline of events detailing the toolkit case. On February 3rd, Swedish climate change activist Greta Thunberg expressed solidarity with protesting farmers in India. Her tweet also posted, deleted, and then reposted a document, the toolkit in question, that listed resources that provide more insight on urgent actions. Several Indian Twitter users claimed significant changes between the toolkit that Thunberg originally shared at 5:20 p.m. but later deleted, and the one she shared at 1:20 a.m. late at night. The Delhi police filed an FIR in the case, and a probe was launched with authorities claiming Khalistani forces behind the matter. The authorities named a Canada-based organization called Poetic Justice Foundation to have alleged a global conspiracy behind the toolkit Thunberg shared. The organization is also alleged as a pro-Khalistani outfit. On February 13, in connection to the probe, Delhi police picked up Disha Ravi from her Bengaluru residence on charges of involvement in the toolkit document. Ravi used to volunteer for Thunberg's Fridays for Future organization in Bengaluru. Accused of circulating the document, Disha Ravi was charged of sedition and criminal conspiracy. Social media saw widespread backlash to Ravi's arrest. Ravi reportedly told the judge that she had merely edited two lines in the toolkit. Ravi said, through her counsel, "If highlighting farmers' protest globally is sedition, I'm better in jail. I am 22, from Karnataka. I have no connection with the Khalistan movement whatsoever." Meanwhile, police identified more names in connection to the toolkit, most prominently Mumbai-based lawyer-cum-activist Nikita Jacob and activist Shantanu Muluk. Jacob and Muluk have been granted transit anticipatory bail by the Bombay High Court. Thunberg and American teen activist Alexandria Villa Senior have extended support to Ravi on social media. After an hour-long discussion on February 20, the court decided to reserve its judgment on Ravi's bail until February 23rd, when she was finally granted bail.